The JAMA Network.
Hey, hey, buddy, are you okay? Are you okay?
These volunteers are learning about cardiac arrest and how to provide compression-only CPR.
This is CPR without the breaths.
They are also learning how to use an automated external defibrillator, or AED.
Open packet and apply pads onto patient's bare skin. Analyzing heart rhythm. Shock advised.
It's very important that people not be afraid to act when one sees a cardiac arrest.
David Foster had a cardiac arrest while attending a Duke basketball game. First responders performed CPR and also used an AED located in the arena.
We know that the chances of survival fall about 10% per minute without any intervention.
Doctors Carolina Malta-Hansen and Christopher Granger from the Duke Clinical Research Institute and co-authors examined the records of nearly 5,000 patients across 11 counties in North Carolina who experienced a cardiac arrest in their community from 2010 to 2013. The goal? To see if ordinary people and first responders were providing CPR and defibrillation, and if this improved survival. The study was done after North Carolina developed statewide initiatives to improve bystander and first response efforts.
Bystander CPR and first responder defibrillation increased remarkably, as did the combination of bystander and first responder efforts.
The study appears in JAMA, Journal of the American Medical Association.
The only improvement was when people got bystander CPR. So this highlights the critical importance for people to learn how to do compression-only CPR, and then to do it, and don't be afraid to do it.
Patients who received bystander or first responder interventions before arrival of the EMS were more likely to survive compared to those who received EMS interventions alone.
Often called the miracle man, David survived his cardiac arrest and is doing well today.
Any intervention is better than no intervention when a person is having a cardiac arrest.
Catherine Dolph, The JAMA Report.